Hello everyone, this is Pooja Sinha from MTech second semester, Department of Food Engineering and Technology, Tejpur University. Today, I will be discussing on modified atmosphere packaging of pomegranate and aerials as an assignment for our course FT571 seminar. I will cover these following topics in the upcoming slides. So, coming to the introduction part, let us first know about the fruit pomegranate. During the last decade, there has been a remarkable increase in the commercial farming of pomegranates globally due to the potential health benefits of this fruit, such as its high antioxidant, anti-mutagenic, anti-hypertension activities, and the ability to reduce liver injury. All these health benefits are primarily because of the edible portion of the pomegranate contains a significant portion of organic acids, soluble solids, polysaccharides, vitamins, fatty acids, and mineral elements which are of nutritional significance. But in spite of numerous health benefits, pomegranate consumption is still limited due to the difficulties of extracting the aerials from the fruit, as the irritation of phenolic metabolites which stain the hands during preparation of the seeds. Also, fruit disorders such as sunburnt husk, splits and cracks, husk scald on the whole fruit reduces marketability and consumer acceptance. Hence, minimally processed pomegranate fruit that is ready to eat aerials presents a more appealing produce to consumers than the whole fruit. However, maintaining the nutritional and microbial quality of pomegranate aerials is a major challenge because minimally processed aerials can easily deteriorate in texture, color, and overall quality due to the active metabolite process because of endogenous enzymatic activity, enhanced respiration rate, etc. Studies have shown that modified atmosphere packaging have the ability to delay quality losses and thus extend the shelf life of fresh or minimally processed or fresh cut produce of this pomegranate. Hence, modified atmosphere packaging sounds an ideal packaging system for the pomegranate aerials. So this was about the introduction. Now let us know a little bit in detail about the pomegranate fruit quality in the next slide. The quality of the pomegranate fruit depends on its physical properties as well as chemical properties. Physical properties include fruit weight, whole fruit and aerial color, juice content and juice dry matter. Chemical properties of pomegranate grown in different regions are slightly different, which shows that these properties vary among agroclimatic regions. Several chemical properties and phytonutrients such as vitamin C, total phenolics, total soluble solids, etc. of various pomegranate cultivars have been reported in various research papers. Now regarding the deterioration in pomegranate fruit quality, in a study conducted in 1984, the results showed that pomegranate fruits have a relatively low respiration rate, which declined with post-harvest to a steady rate of 8 ml per kg per hour for about 3 months, and ethylene production was in trace quantity, which is less than 0.2 micro ml per kg per hour, when stored at 20 degrees centigrade for 2 weeks. This observed metabolic process confirms that pomegranate is a non-climacteric fruit, being that it exhibits no drastic changes in post-harvest physiology and composition. Deterioration in pomegranate fruit quality can result from following four reasons. First one is chilling injury, which occurs when the fruit are stored below 5 degrees centigrade for longer than 1 month. Deterioration can also occur from husk scalding, which is a superficial browning that is restricted to the husk only. This husk scald occurs due to the oxidation of phenolic compounds. To avoid this, the pomegranate fruit should be stored at 2 degrees centigrade in 2% oxygen storage. Third one is due to weight loss. When the pomegranate loses weight, it leads to hardening and browning of the rind and aerials. In one study, it was observed that after 6 weeks of storage at 8 degrees centigrade, unwrapped and untreated pomegranate had a weight loss of 5.1%, while firm wrapped fruit lost only 0.6% weight. Fourth one is the decay, which is another limiting factor for long-term storage and a major cause of post-harvest losses in pomegranate. The decay is caused by various pathogens. This decaying can be prevented if pomegranate fruits are treated with flu-deoxynil and stored at 10 degrees centigrade for 2.2 to 5 months. Now let's move on ahead with the modified atmosphere packaging general overview. The basic definition of MAP is that it is a dynamic process of altering the gaseous composition within a package, which is achieved by interaction of two processes, that is, the respiration rate of the produce and the transfer of gases through the packaging material. Basically, there are two methods to achieve this modified atmosphere. One is passive modification, where the modified atmosphere is created inside a package using natural air composition and relying on produce respiration to attain the desired gas mixture. The other one is active modification, where the process involves a quick process of gas replacement or the use of gas scavenging agents so as to establish a desired mixture within the package. This active modification is much quicker as compared to passive modification, and hence it is much preferred. Some of the benefits of MAP includes reduction of respiratory activity, delaying in softening and ripening of the fruit, and reduced incidence of various physiological disorders and pathogenic infestations. Next is the major three gases that are used in the modified atmosphere packaging. First one is carbon dioxide, which is a colorless gas, and it gives off a slight pungent smell at a very high concentration. High concentration of this gas can retard the microbial growth efficiently. Second one is nitrogen, which is an inert gas that is used to expel air, especially oxygen, out of the package. The third one is the oxygen, which helps to keep the natural color of the food and helps in easy and sufficient respiration of the fruits and vegetables. So, moving on ahead, let me discuss the factors that affect the modified atmosphere packages. These factors include commodity factors and environmental factors. Under commodity factors are respiration, which is an oxidative breakdown of starch, sugar, and organic acids to single molecule with the concurrent production of energy. Second one is the ethylene production and sensitivity. Ethylene is a plant hormone which regulates fruit ripening. Exposure of fruits to ethylene advances the onset of irreversible rise in respiration and rapid ripening. Third is temperature. Temperature plays an important role because metabolic processes, including respiration and ripening rate, since they are very much sensitive to temperature. It is known that with every 10 degree rise in temperature, biological reaction increase up to 2 to 3 folds. Fourth one is optimum relative humidity. If the relative humidity is low, it can increase the transpiration damage and will lead to desiccation, increased respiration, and an unmarketable product. There is a danger that if the relative humidity gets too high, moisture condensation will occur, which will favor microbial growth. Now, coming to the environmental factors. First one is temperature and humidity. Increase in temperature of the outside environment increases the film permeability, which with carbon dioxide permeability responding more than oxygen permeability. Hence, a film which might be suitable for one temperature might not be appropriate at other temperature. Second one is light. In the presence of light, green vegetable consume sustainable amount of carbon dioxide and produce oxygen through photosynthesis. This reaction can antagonize the respiration process, which are acting in maintenance of specified modified atmosphere within the package. The last one is sanitation factors. The presence of high humidity inside the package may enhance the growth of plant pathogens. Hence, to prevent this, fungicide treatment of packaged produce is very much important. So moving on ahead, in the next slide, let me discuss regarding advances in MAP sensing and monitoring. The desire to improve the safety of MAP products and to extend the technology to a broader spectrum of products led to the introduction of smart or active or intelligent packaging system. This advancement is considered as the most significant area of development of MAP technology. Smart packaging can be defined as an interaction between the packaging system and the product itself, which confers intelligence appropriate to function and use of product with the ability to sense or to be sensed and to communicate. And due to this interaction, there is often a visible change in the properties of the indicator used, such as color change, which allows the consumer the privilege to monitor the safety and shelf life of the product. This smart packaging is mainly classified into two types: active packaging and intelligent packaging. Active packaging involves the interaction between the package and food product in order to extend the shelf life of the product. This involves the addition of active agents into the packaged food product, such as oxygen and carbon dioxide scavengers, carbon dioxide, ethylene and water vapor removals, and aroma releasing compounds. Two approaches to the development of oxygen scavenging system have been reported. However, the most successful in commercial application has been the use of sachets and labels that are included in the packaged product. The other approach is the development of oxygen scavenging films with immobilized oxidizing enzymes such as alcohol oxidase and glucose oxidase on the inner surface of the packaging film. Hence, the cost of this approach makes commercial application unlikely. Now, regarding the intelligent packaging. Intelligent packaging involves the monitoring of the quality, safety of a food product while providing an indication or information that can be helpful in the distribution or supply chain. Example of such indicators include time temperature indicator, in short TTI, radio frequency identification or RFID tags, gas indicators, sensors, leak detection and edible films. Now let us discuss in detail about the TTI, RFID and gas indicators. TTIs are often small self-adhesive labels attached onto individual consumer packages or shipping containers. They provide a visual indication of temperature history, which gradually changes over time, and this rate of change observed is directly proportional to the increase in temperature. TTIs are more reliable in monitoring the remaining shelf life of perishable produce than expiration dates, because expiration dates assumes a specific temperature history, but variation from this temperature could result in premature spoilage and possible sales of spoiled product. While TTIs respond directly to temperature and reflect the temperature history of the product, the setback, however, is that TTIs are sensitive to active radiation and must be stored at a low temperature prior to usage. This criteria elevates the cost of production. RFID or radio frequency identification tags. This involves a wireless transfer and collection of data. A reader emits radio waves which capture data from a RFID tag, and the data are transferred onto a host computer for analysis and interpretation, which guides in decision making. RFID tags can be classified into two types. This include passive tags and active tags. The passive tags are powered by the energy supplied via the reader and have a reading range of about 15 feet, while active tags are battery powered with a broadcasting range of up to 100 feet. The ability of wireless transfer of data enables real-time monitoring of product and provides a reduction in inventory cost. Last one is the gas indicators. In a modified atmosphere packaged product, the respiration of fresh produce or gas flux through the packaging film or gas generation by spoilage microbes or leakage may cause a change in gaseous composition within the package. Gas indicators in the form of labels or print on the packaging film can help to monitor the safety and quality of the packaged produce. Oxygen indicators are most frequently used as gas indicators due to the ability of oxygen to cause oxidative color change and enhanced microbial spoilage. Carbon dioxide indicator can be used to detect early spoilage as well as to monitor the level of carbon dioxide within modified atmosphere packages, which is on transit or within the storage facility. Next is the MAP of whole pomegranate fruit. The storage conditions and temperature of pomegranate fruit varies depending on the cultivar of interest. Cultivar is a plant variety that has been produced in cultivation by selective breeding. Different cultivar that were studied includes Moller cultivar, Moller D. Elche cultivar, Variety Wonderful cultivar, Hikasner cultivar, Ganesh cultivar, and Primozol cultivar. For Moller cultivar, a study recommended that a controlled atmosphere of 5% oxygen and 5% carbon dioxide storage at 5 degrees centigrade with relative humidity above 95% helps to minimize decay, weight loss, and chilling injuries. Contrast to this, in another study conducted by Kader, 1995, recommended a gas composition of 3% to 5% oxygen and 5% to 10% carbon dioxide at 5 degrees centigrade. Some studies have also shown that the storage of pomegranate at temperature lower than 5 degrees centigrade resulted in chilling injuries. In another study of Moller cultivar, it was found that after 4 months of storage at 1 degree centigrade, the lowest weight loss in the fruit was seen, which was treated with antitranspirant. For Moller D. Elche cultivar, in a study conducted in 2000, investigated the effect of different packaging films. It was observed that at 2 and 5 degrees centigrade, within the sealed UPP bags, traces of C2H2 were detected occasionally, while within the perforated bags, the atmospheric conditions was practically like air at the end of 12-week storage. At the end of the shelf life, all treatments at 5 degrees centigrade had slightly decreased values. The value of titrable acid at the end of 12-week storage at 2 or 5 degrees centigrade were lower than those at harvest, except for perforated polypropylene at 5 degrees centigrade. Also, during the refrigerated storage at 2 and 5 degrees centigrade, the soluble solid content and titrable acid ratio increased significantly in MAP stored fruits due to decrease in titrable acid. Based on their assessment, the best treatment for maintaining red color of the aerials at the end of cold storage was perforated polypropylene at 5 degrees centigrade, and lowest physiological disorders were found in MAP treated at both refrigerated storage temperatures. Now, regarding Variety Wonderful cultivar, a study was conducted on whole pomegranate Variety Wonderful cultivar, which was harvested from a commercial orchards in central coastal region of Israel in 2009. The results recommended the use of either extend easy tier or regular extend modified atmosphere or modified humidity bags in 4 to 5 kg export cartons. The study led to the observation that extend film had a higher moisture vapor transmission rates in comparison to conventional polyethylene and polypropylene films, which helps to eliminate moisture. For higher Hikasner cultivar pomegranate, a study was conducted by Bayram in 2009, where the pomegranate are exposed to 3 different packaging treatments. This include a steric film wrapped, modified atmosphere packaging, and controlled with no treatment. The fruits were stored for 6 months at 6 degrees centigrade and relative humidity greater than 90%. The study observed that the least weight loss of 3% in the modified atmosphere packaged fruit compared with 24% recorded for the control treatment and the MAP treatment gave the best visual and quality score at the end of the storage period. For soft-seeded Ganesh cultivar, Nanda in 2001 studied the effect of shrink film prepping of two polyolefin films, that is BDF 2001 and D955. And skin coating with sucrose polyester on quality and shelf life. They observed that the shrink wrapping significantly reduced the respiration rate compared with non-wrapped pomegranates, but no detectable level of ethylene was found during storage at ambient and low temperature conditions, both in wrapped and non-wrapped fruits. After 25 days of storage at 25 degrees centigrade, fruit shrink wrapped with BDF and D95 films lost about 1.5% and 2.3% weight respectively as compared with 14% and 7.8% weight lost in non-wrapped and SPE treated fruits. For the pomegranate primosol cultivar, in a recent study by D. Aquino 2010 investigated the effect of film wrapping and flue application on reducing the occurrence of husk scald, weight loss, and decay of pomegranate fruit. Flue is a synthetic analog of pyrrolnitrine, which is recently registered for controlling the post-harvest decay of various horticultural crops, including pomegranate in USA. They observed that a reduction in respiration with the first week of storage at 8 degrees centigrade and 90% relative humidity and no significant difference was detected among treatment after 6 weeks. However, from the 10th week, respiration in control treatment was significantly lower in wrapped fruits. Fluodeoxynil application alone and in combination with wrapping effectively controlled mold growth with 50 to 67% less decay in comparison to control treatment after 12 weeks at 8 degrees centigrade, including 1 week shelf life. So that was all about the MAP of whole pomegranate fruit. Now coming to the next slide topic, that is MAP of minimally processed pomegranate edibles. As you can see, the table gives the summary of the modified atmosphere packaging of pomegranate edibles of different cultivars, different types of packaging films with different atmospheric composition along with temperature and duration. As you can see from the table, different cultivars when kept at different modified atmospheric composition and packed in different films, their storage time of each pomegranate type was very much different from one another. If one had storage time of 12 weeks, the other would have 7 days and so on. This shows that cultivar differences is essential in optimizing the storage condition of pomegranate. For the conclusion, I would like to say that in spite of several benefits of MAP, its application for pomegranate whole fruits and minimally processed edibles is still limited due to the challenges such as choice of polymeric films, as no single polymeric film can offer all the required properties of MAP. And according to various studies, it has been shown that MAP technology is able to extend the shelf life of pomegranate whole fruit and edibles. However, novel technologies such as smart packaging offer the potential of further increase in shelf life and the safety of MAP pomegranate whole fruit and edibles. For example, to ensure microbial safety of packaged fruit and edibles, storage temperature of packages can be strictly monitored with the use of TTI. But MAP is still restricted to certain cultivars either because of the profit margins gained from the packaging them. As new cultivars are emerging from commercial farming, it is expedient to investigate the post-harvest physiology for both newly introduced cultivars and other unstudied cultivars. And it is also known that different pomegranate cultivars responded differently to MAP. Hence, experimental studies should be carried out separately for each cultivar with more informative output on the metabolic properties under various conditions. Lastly, on a broader front, the place of MAP in general produce distribution system needs to be studied, and the feasibility of altering handling practices to accommodate MAP should be further investigated. And this is my references. Thank you.